Hi, this is Debbie from Langdida Design, and thank you for joining me to take a look at the Samsa Stamp Stamptember 2021 exclusive from Honeybee Stamps. This is a limited edition stamp set for Stamptember, and as such, once it's gone and won't be restocked. Let's jump straight into making the card. The Honeybee Stamptember stamp set, it's called Be a Sunflower, has a wonderful wide sunflower border along with a bunch of sweet sentiments. I knew it would look great stamped over a colourful background. I chose watercolours as my medium of choice, but you could use ink blending, ink smushing, sprays or similar. I took a piece of Fabriano Artistico cold pressed watercolour card and I decided to be a little bit fancy. I usually take my card to a board and create my background before trimming the panel to size. However, just recently, I've enjoyed precisely taping the edges of the card to leave a nice crisp white border once the tape is lifted. To get a good effect, the taping needs to be even all the way round, and so I penciled in the border first before lightening the pencil lines with a kneaded eraser so that I could still see them, but they wouldn't be distracting if they got trapped under a watercolour layer. When I taped the card to the board, I did try and add the tape very slightly over the lines to prevent this happening. Oh, and I often reuse tape if it's still in good condition from my previous project. I was going to be working with watercolours plus lots of water slushing around. To work with this wet and wet technique, I find it best to decide on a colour palette beforehand, and then you can dip into the colours quickly as you're working. I mixed up a muted autumnal set of colours according to what I was seeing out of my window, where I have a bank of sunflowers against the back fence that I see as I sit and paint. A rich but deep green, yellow ochre, bright yellow, but also some hints of dusky pinks to warm things up a touch. And I have a blue mix, which is very dilute indigo with a dash of white gesso. I've been enjoying using this chalky blue for backgrounds recently and thought I might bring it in for the sky. In the end, it only makes a brief appearance though. I loaded a brush with the rich green mix and went straight to the paper along the bottom edge where the shadows would be deepest. Quickly, I dipped my brush into the water jar and rinsed some of the paint away. I know, such a waste, but on this occasion I only planned on creating one piece and didn't need the paint for anything else. If you were making multiples, you could swish the paint over several panels and then bring water in with a separate brush. However, I dipped into the water and then brought the brush back to the card and got the paint moving with a much more watery concentration. Into this wet puddle of paint, I used a smaller brush to bring in the yellow ochre, yellow and pink. I kept the colours more dilute at the top of the page with water, and then I tried to bring in the blue, and I didn't like it on this occasion. I preferred the lighter washed out colours fading to virtually nothing at the top of the panel, and so I washed most of the blue off the top with a watery brush. A little still remains, which I did just like that hint of blue to the sky, but nothing to take away from that lovely mix of greens and yellows going on. One tip is that when I'm painting or doing anything much in the craft room, I keep a soft cloth at hand. I use it for mopping up mistakes, excess paint, wiping off stamps before putting them away, cleaning my worktop and such. I have a few of them and then pop them through the wash together. It's so much better for the environment, I feel, than baby wipes. Don't get me wrong, I have a pack of baby wipes to hand too, but try and remember to use the cloth when I can. Okay, I'm not always good at leaving paints to do their thing, and for this card, I messed around a fair bit. I added more concentrated paint mixes to deepen the shadows, added water splatter for interesting effects, and also used a brush with water to draw along the top line of the panel, and the water pulls the paint towards it, encouraging movement, blending and mixing. I left the panel to dry and so far I have a piece with soft blends, but I wanted to add some of those hard lines you see sometimes with watercolours. And the way to do this is to add a dilute layer of colour over the top of the base layer and then dry. I'm using a dilute pale colour so it won't compete with the underneath layer, but when dried without adding water to blend, then you get those hard watery lines. Okay, this panel was done and it was time to reveal the edges and see if the tape worked. I had my doubts because I'd reused the tape, so perhaps didn't have the best seal, and also I'd used a lot of water and so there was a likelihood of a leak. And yes, when I lifted the tape, I did have a couple of spots. Possibly it shouldn't matter, but I'm a bit of a perfectionist, and so once I realised I had the leaks, I knew I wanted to cut the panel down. and so it didn't matter anymore when I stamped the sunflower image over the top if the edges overlapped the white border, because I knew I would be trimming those off shortly anyway. I lined up the sunflower image so that the sunflower heads would sit in the yellow areas of the watercolour background. I then stamped them in VersaFine Clair Pinecone ink. I felt that dark brown was just a tad softer in colour than my usual black and would fit in with the season and colour scheme. I had to stamp the image several times because the cold press watercolour card I used had texture to the surface. This is great for watercolouring, but it does make it a bit tricky to get a good impression first time. However, that isn't a worry when using the Misti. I just kept inking and stamping until I was happy. While I had the Misti out, I also took one of the greetings from the Bia Sunflower set and stamped it in clear embossing ink on vellum I treated with an anti-static powder. I sprinkled with white embossing powder before heat setting and then trimmed to a banner. I set the greeting aside for a moment while I finished the watercolour panel. I added a little extra colour to the leaves and petals. In the end, you can barely tell, but I felt a bit of colour helped to define the sunflowers from the rest of the background. I love splatter. I know it's not for everyone, but an autumnal scene I feel is perfect for splatter. It gives that hazy feel and insects buzzing around visiting the last of the flowers. I started with a splatter of green over the lower portion of the panel and then worked through yellow ochre and into yellow. And while those colours were still wet, I splattered with white gouache so that some of the gouache mixed with the paint. I then dried the panel before giving it a final splatter with gouache, and I made sure the mix was nice and concentrated to give small, opaque, defined droplets. At this point, I trimmed the panel down. In the end, I think it was just under 3.5 by 5 inches. I quite like having a torn edge to vellum currently, and so I tore one end of the sentiment strip and then wrapped the other end around the panel and secured on the back with micropore tape. The greeting is now firmly attached on the back, but to get it to lay nicely on the front was going to take some adhesive. My favourite way to adhere vellum is to use tiny pieces of foam tape and then add them behind the embossed greeting. I took a thin piece of foam tape and removed the backer before cutting it into small pieces. These stick to the blade of the scissors and then I pick them up with a pair of tweezers and add them to the vellum. I like to have at least 5 pieces dotted around and then I simply fold the vellum over and press down. I pulled out my 3 favourite card bases cut from Nina Desert Storm, Fog and Ivory card. I keep a bunch of these cut and scored ready for when I want them. I laid the watercolour panel on each and decided I like the contrast between the ivory and the colourful watercolour. I added foam tape to the back of the panel and adhered to the card front. I trimmed the card front to give an equal border for each edge and then finished off with a few sequins and pearls. I paired the card with an envelope and that's it for this simple card. I know I get carried away with watercolour and splatter, but if this design was paired back, you could ink blend in greens and yellows and stamp over the top in black and keep it that straightforward and simple. Well, that's me for today. I hope you're enjoying Stamptember so far and all the inspiration dropping on a daily basis. I'll leave links in the YouTube description to the products that I've used, as well as a coordinating link to the blog post over at limedutydesign.com. I want to thank you for joining me, and if you've enjoyed this tutorial, I'd be delighted if you subscribe to this channel. And before I go, here's a couple more videos to check out. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.